time-lapse video are in fact set of photos which are done in certain time interval and then they are put together into one video. The similar effect you can do also with camera if the frequency of your camera will be much slower. Why you need time-lapse video? In fact, time-lapse gives you the opportunity to show longer time period into very short time and the changes which are there. The typical time-lapse are on the sky as the clouds are moving. Sunrise is very nice time-lapse video. Or the construction, imagine. I don't mean the construction of building because it lasts the years, but construction of Swiss stand or anything which lasts maybe a few hours. If you make photos or videos with time-lapse, you can compress it into a few minutes and you will see how this construction was built. So what do you need to make time-lapse video? In fact, as usual, you need camera. But first of all, you need a tripod. No matter which tripod you have, but it should be the tripod which is able to fix your camera even if there is a wind or some not very favorable weather conditions. So sometimes you can put your camera on the table or on the floor, but it's not recommended because it can slightly move and then the object will move. So you need a tripod, whichever. This is my favorite tripod, which I love because it's very easily to be folded and unfolded. As you can see, it's a matter of seconds. How can I do it? And oops, and it's done. Then you need a camera. In fact, in let's say all the cameras didn't have the option for time-lapse. New cameras, they have the option for time-lapse, but if you have a camera which doesn't have a time-lapse option, then you can do it also but manually. In fact, in this case, you need a remote control. If your camera has the option, has the socket for remote control, and you need a time. Watch, maybe with stops or with seconds, because you will measure the shots in seconds or the space between shots in seconds. But which is the best time interval between two shots? Well, it really depends on what you are going to make a photos or what was your subject. If it is maybe night sky, the stars are moving very, very slowly. So in this case, you need maybe to be by your camera 2 or 3 hours. And if your video should have maybe 5 to 10 seconds, final video, 5 to 10 seconds, with the speed about 25 image per second, it means that for 10 minutes video, you need 250 shots. And so if you calculate 250 shots and maybe one shot per minute, you are exactly at 4 hours. So if you take 2 shots per minute every 30 seconds, it will last 2 hours. Unfortunately, the result you only see once you finish your time lapse. And if you did it manually, as I described the first option, then you really need to measure time and press the shutter every dedicated, I don't know, 20, 30, 50 seconds. If your object is moving faster, maybe as I said, there is some construction in the park and they are building new attraction in the park for the occasion of some festival or some big Swiss stand and you want to make a photo from this, in this case the objects are moving very fast. In this case I would recommend maybe to make one photo per second. So in 1 minute you would make 60 photos, which if you compile it into video, it's about 2 seconds of video. So in this case maybe 10 minutes of time-lapse would give you maybe 20 seconds of final video. So this is very important that you think at the beginning how fast your objects are moving, because if they are moving very fast and your interval will be long, then you will not be able to see the fluence of the object. On the contrary, if they move slow or they move fast and you give very slow intervals, it's not so bad, because then you can compress, in fact final video can have something from 15 to 50 or even 60 shots per second. So if your object moved slowly and you made too many or maybe, I don't know, 100,000 shots, let's say, then you can still compress those 1,000 shots to video which will last 20 seconds, because you will make the frequency of video 50 images per second. I believe you have some new camera which has this option, and there are few types of camera. This is a compact camera, and this compact camera has preset options for time lapse. So there is something from fast moving, which is about 10 minutes of time shot on the one end, and another end is about its night sky or some slow moving object, which is 150 minutes, which is 2.5 hours. So there are only 4 presets here, and I must think which one of those. So first is 10 seconds, 10 minutes, second is 50 minutes, and third and fourth are 1 hour 50. It depends if I do it during the day or during the night. 50 minutes is usually maybe sunrise or sunset or something like this. If you have better camera like this, then you are completely free in setup of your time-lapse options. First of all, you can even set up when the time-lapse shall start. For example, if it is sunrise and you are lazy to wake up at 4 or 5 in the morning, then you can place your camera on the tripod and set it up to start taking shots at maybe 4:50. Check in the calendar what time is the sunrise, but don't forget, if you want to make photos of sunrise, the very nice colors come before the sunrise is really on the horizon. So maybe start 10-20 minutes before planned or forecasted sunrise. Then what you can do is you can set up the interval, how many seconds will be among the shots, and also total number of the shots, which will in fact give you the total time, how long will your camera take these time-lapse shots, or how long this video will last. The another option which this camera has, that you can, or might have new camera, you can have a different format. Standard format is full HD, but modern camera can offer you even 4K, because the images which camera takes is maybe full frame images, which is might be 16 megapixels, and this will be automatically, your camera will process this. In fact, you can make it after process, but for this you need a special software. But if you rely on your camera, you can set up which will be format of your, or resolution of your time lapse, and also which will be the frequency. So how many shots per second, it will give you the duration or the length of your time lapse. I would recommend somewhere maybe between 15 and 30 images per second, and then your final video will be recorded to your SD card or memory card. In fact, some camera will keep original original photos, some of them will delete, because imagine if you made cameras time-lapse with 500 shots, be aware that you must have full battery when you start, and you must have empty memory card when you start, because it's quite a huge amount of data. So it may happen that your time-lapse will not even finish because your memory would be full or your battery will be exhausted. So this is very important. When you think about time-lapse, always take with you a new fresh battery and try to have empty at least 32 gigabyte card. So this is all about time-lapse. I will show you some more time-lapses, and see you in the next video. If you like it, give us the like or subscribe to the channel. Thank you, goodbye.